The Suffolk Championship is up for grabs. The checkered roof on that car indicates that the title already held by that driver is the British Championship. That's car number 392, Henry Stace from Wittersham. He's got himself a good position on the grid here, right on the front row. A lot of cars in this one. There must be getting on for 40 competitors taking part here. And we're racing over 20 laps. Look at that mass of steel ready to go. Normal one lap just to warm up with the pace car controlling them in front. And then as they come through down this straight, completing that one warming up lap, the green flag will be dropped by the starting marshal there under his hand on the right. And then all hell will be let loose for 20 laps. And at the end of it all, we shall have the Suffolk. On our way we go. And 180 decides that it's better to go a little wide. Gary Huggins leans all over. Leans all over Henry Stace, but he gets his come up and says two more come past, but it's Henry Stace, in fact, who gets held up just as much as the rest come barging their way through. Of course, when there's a block trap, you don't bother to stop, you just wash your way through. That's what banger racing is all about. So through they come. 662 went through there. I think he's up in front, Gary Parsons, but we'll sort him out once they settle down. That's the way to get rid of them. Just push your way through, a little bit of contact, and then foot hard down, one either side, leaving poor old 12 sitting in the middle of the track there, but doesn't matter, he'll have to sort himself out as best he can. 473 trying to rejoin, if he can just find a gap to get back in. Adrian Tillman from Eastbourne. 33 gets shoved around. Simon Reed, he's a local guy from Wisbeach. Well, now 74 is the leader and 662 in fact is in second place. Slight lack of steering from 114. Mad Malcolm Girling in 168 getting jammed against the fence. 12 trying to abandon, gets now behind the safety of the fence. So four laps gone, 74 is the leader, 662 is second, 58 is third, so that's the order. You see them go flashing through. 74, Chris Colliver. Back of this little group. Oh, 662, in fact, has just moved ahead of him. So 662 is Gary Parsons. 74, right behind him. No, 177's not going to go much further. John Robinson, only got to go to Newmarket though. That's the leader, the one with the balloon on the fin number. Car number 662, Gary Parsons, is in the lead. Car number 74 is in second place, Chris Colliver from Tooting. And behind him we go to 442, I think it is, and then 217. Oh, leader gets himself a little bit of bother there, just extricates himself in time. Build up a bit of speed quickly before the rest of them come after him. 662. Lost 74 somewhere along the way. 442 is now second. Oh, 74 just grinds to a halt over on the far side. Up on the bend. Oh, he's got a puncture. That's what's really the trouble there. And trouble there for car number 97. Big Rover bludgeons its way through car number 473. They're good cars for this race, plenty of weight there. 534 desperately trying to rejoin off the speedway track. David Last from Ipswich. Here's 442, another big Rover as we come towards the closing stages of this one now. 442 in fact is second, 662 is the leader. That's the lead car. 662, Gary Parsons of Ipswich, he's in the lead. And 442 is quite some way back, and 114 is getting a slightly new perspective on the race. He's quite okay while he's in there. That one is one of the sort of safest places. 74, who was contesting the places earlier on. He's in there now. So 662 the leader, 442 is second, and 217 is third. There's the leader, 662. Front end had a bit of a bump there by the look of it. Trying to find his way past some of those slower cars. He's got a reasonable lead. He's got a reasonable lead on the rest of the field. It's Mad Malcolm Girling backing off frantically in 168, trying to get out of the way of the rest of the traffic as they all come thundering through. 129, Mick Conlon trying to go well, trying to get back. It's a relatively undamaged car and going well, but this one is still up front, and smoke coming from the rear near side now. A little bit of tyre rubbing as the car pitches over as it goes round the bends. Three more laps to go as the big Jag bundles 534 out of the way. It's number eight going well. But up front, 662, 442, 129 is the order now. So it's 662, Gary Parsons. 442 is the big white Rover. He's still back there in second place. It's one more lap to go now for 662, who comes through. There's the second place, 442. But he is now something like a quarter of a lap, in fact, behind the leader. And 662 has just been spun out. And the leader is gone now. He's going to finish up facing the right way. Can he get going quickly? The car going past right now is 442. Just went flashing through. That's the car that was in second place and is now in the lead. And 129, that is third. 662 is just going round. And the checkered flag is at the ready. And this one is going to come over the line and win it. 442. That was really a bit of luck for him. He managed just to scrape over the line. Chico Gray from Purbrook comes home to win that one after poor old 662, of course, got shunted out right in the closing stages. 129 came home in second place, Mick Conlon, and third was poor old 662, who got done out of it right at the death. So it's 442, Chico Gray, the winner.